Oh, hello. Also, welcome to another edition of Only in Monroe. I'm Stephen Colbert, filling in for your usual hosts, Michelle Bauman and Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson. I'm not sure how many people that is, but none of them could be here tonight. And I'm so grateful for the hospitality shown to me by everyone here at Monroe Public Access Cable Television, or MPACT. They are all team players, because they know there is no I in MPACT. I've only been here a day, but I've already grown close to station manager Millward Boudry and my volunteer cameramen, Lee Markham, Jeff Brown, and Faye Markham. You guys are the best. Thanks so much. Since my last show ended in December, I've been itching to host a talk show again, but my new theater is not ready yet, so I decided to head over to Monroe, Michigan, look around, and give it a Michigander. Obviously, native Monrovians know a lot about this town already, but people all over the world can subscribe to MPACT's YouTube channel to binge watch 2014 city council meetings. Spoiler alert, hope you didn't get too attached to that free parking on Cass Street. Did not end well. So as the temporary host of Only in Monroe, I felt it was my duty to educate myself about what makes Monroe, Mungo. This is Monroe. Monroe is located in beautiful southeast Michigan, the place where mom clips America's mitten onto the sleeve of Indiana. In 1817, Monroe was named for newly elected President James Monroe, who bought the naming rights to the city to promote Jimmy Monroe's jacked jalapeno lard on a hardtack biscuit. Ba-da-ba-ba-da, it's sustenance. Monroe is the hometown of General George Armstrong Custer. Now, while everyone knows that Little Bighorn was Custer's last stand, few realize that Monroe was his first stand. The city itself is located on scenic Breast Bay. There's nothing locals love more than heading out on the lake and motorboating the Breast. Monroe is also the birthplace of Lazy Boy. Lazy Boy, don't sit there, that's Dad's chair. The Lazy Boy was invented in 1928 by two cousins who wanted to simulate, quote, nature's way of relaxing, and it's true. You see this way of relaxing all the time on the Serengeti. The Monroe Boat Club is celebrated for an annual dinner where they serve the local delicacy, muskrat. If you're wondering what muskrat tastes like, imagine eating a rat, but with more musk. And if you're gonna have an adult beverage with your muskrat, and I do recommend it, remember the old saying, beer before muskrat, never sicker. Muskrat before beer, still not feeling great. Now, I want to assure fans of Only in Monroe that I want to do a show that would make Michelle Bauman and Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson proud, all of them, even though they were not available to host tonight. So let's welcome tonight's first guests, Michelle Bauman and Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, yes.
Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson. Thank you so much for being here.
For hosting for us this evening.
Now, what was the engagement that you had to go to that kept you unable to host the show?
Well, we were going to be guests on Stephen Colbert's show.
Yeah, on your show. We're guests on your show. Cool.
Okay.
Yes.
Fantastic. Let's get right into the heat of the meat here. Michelle Bauman, you're a registered nurse.
I am.
You're a teacher and a proud mom.
I am.
Fantastic. Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson, you are also a registered nurse,
yes,
a proud mom, and the winner of the 1988 Miss America pageant.
That's right.
Oh, okay. What happens if you feature something on Only in Monroe and then you find out it also happens someplace else? Do you have to issue a retraction?
No, we would call them and tell them to take it down right away.
So right.
Stop their production. Yeah. It's ours.
It's a turf war between Monroe
absolutely.
And all other counties. Yeah. When you say Only Monroe, do you mean the county or the town of Monroe?
It's a county.
Okay.
It's a county.
There's no town called Monroe?
There is, but only Monroe. We talk about the whole county and everything that's happening here. We've got some great events, but we're territorial.
I think of you guys as the Kathy Lee and Hoda of Monroe.
I'm Kathy Lee. She is my favorite.
Speaking of which,
great.
Who wants a glass of wine?
Oh, oh my God.
Well, there we go.
I don't know if this is legal to do.
I don't know either,
but if anyone is watching, this is water. Can I hit you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, that looks nice and clear. Where'd you get this water at, Stephen?
I got this from the local sewage treatment plant.
I was going to say, not out my back door, right, River Raisin?
No. I got this right out of the River Raisin. But you know, it's cresting. The River Raisin is cresting.
Oh, yes, we know.
Yes.
Dundee is close.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To only in Monroe.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, Daddy's water burns a little bit.
Nice.
That's nice.
I like this kind of water.
I hope that's legal.
Okay, I'm going to talk to you about some of the...
I don't know, check with legal.
We're going to have to check.
I want to talk to you about one of the episodes that I saw you guys do a little while back, where you were talking to Joe Bell from the Mall of Monroe.
Right.
Is it true that you guys sometimes go to the movie theater, but not to see a movie, just to buy popcorn and take it home?
I do. My daughter works there, and they do have really good popcorn.
Is that why you can go do that? Because normally at a movie theater, you have to actually buy a ticket, get it torn, go in, and there's the concession stand.
But you can buy popcorn.
You can.
Sure.
And in Monroe, you can.
Only in Monroe.
I would say so, because if you tried that in New York, they would tase you.
I know. I have been there. Oh, no.
Oh, been there.
Been there, done that. No, I'm
teasing. She has not been tased. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Now, Kaylani Ray Rofko Wilson.
Yes.
When you won Miss America in 1988, what was the biggest surprise for you? Was it that you had no legislative power? What surprised you about being Miss America?
You know, I think the most surprising thing was that all of a sudden I had a title that was recognized by everyone over the age of four. A little bit freaky.
Right.
Because everywhere you went, they just saw the crown. And I think the power behind the title. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'd go into a place and people just wanted to hear what she had to say. And as a nurse, coming during a nursing shortage, it worked out really, really nice.
Well, how great would it be if you were like in a hospital and they say, your nurse is going to be in here,
that
and
happened.
She's Miss America.
That happened. That happened. Yes, yes.
That would pull me back from the brink.
It was kind of fun. It was like,
exactly.
Yeah. One of my patients down in Toledo, the first thing he said was, oh my gosh, he called the Toledo Blade, I think, and said, do you know where the new Miss America has given me shots? And I just was like, oh my gosh, don't talk to the press. just fun. But it was a shocker. It was a shocker. And it wasn't because I had a great wave or anything like that. It just was a shocker.
What is the official wave? What is the official wave of
are you ready?
Beauty queens?
Can we
all do it? Let's do this.
Yes, we can do it. Okay. So bring your middle finger slightly towards your thumb.
Okay.
That's perfect. And then just twist your wrist.
Like this?
That's right.
So
I am really
there you go.
I get a lot of practice.
She practices every day before our show. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
You know, and
that's
actually,
great.
You do that very well.
Thank you very much.
A little bit better than I thought you would, but that's good. That's
great.
We're not worried about that at all.
I've got the hips of a beauty queen.
There you go.
can we trash talk Miss USA for a second?
Well, okay.
Miss America is where it's at, right? Miss America is
it's
the original.
That's right. There you go.
Much older. Much higher
1921.
Status.
1921.
Miss USA, I think, was invented in the Carter administration, wasn't it?
In the 40s.
In the 1940s.
In the 40s, I think.
They had they had a shortage of Miss Americas because all Miss Americas were off fighting the Nazis
at
the time. They had to go. They had to go with a second tier Miss National Woman.
There you go.
That's great. Now, did you guys, you and Miss USA at the time, do you remember who was Miss USA when you were Miss America?
I don't. But we actually have, you know, my daughter's the current Miss Monroe County.
Oh, really? Is she
going
to try to become
Michigan? Well, she tried. She tried. She didn't make top 10, but she did awesome.
Uh-huh.
And she's going to keep trying. She needs some scholarship for school. But
right.
She's
can
one
you
of
go
her
more
closest.
Than once? Can you try more than once?
You can try more than once for a state title. But
you can't
everyone who goes
once.
To Miss America, it's just a one-shot deal.
All right.
But actually, it's kind of ironic that one of her good friends is the current Miss Michigan teen, USA.
Now, in Michigan, isn't it actually technically Michigan?
No. That's only after you've been drinking our water. And then it's Michigan.
After you had a little sewage water.
Cheers. Okay.
Yeah, that's it. Sorry, Michelle.
Michelle Bauman, I have to take issue with you for a second. Again, I need to take issue
good.
With you. You're ready for this.
I'm so worried. You are on Facebook.
I was watching. Are you guys on Facebook?
I am.
Yeah.
It's my
do you
job.
Facebook a lot?
Yeah.
I'm not on Facebook. Sell me on Facebook.
Know.
Why should I be on?
Because if you wanted to watch what I do every day, probably from go to the mall to the gas station to the airport,
you'll know everything about her.
If I was on Facebook, I'd be able to give me the rundown again of the, agenda.
From about 6 a.m. to about 10 p.m.
So at 6 a.m., I know what you're doing at all times.
Yes.
Is this some sort of like government program where you have to keep like one of those locator bracelets on your ankle? Why do I know so much about you all the time?
I guess because I thought I was so interesting.
I'm not sure.
It's so much fun.
I learned something about you on another recent episode, a different episode, mm-hmm. than the popcorn episode,
oh,
but a different episode where you said that you spent a fair amount of time up in Saginaw, right?
Mm-hmm.
And how long of a drive is that from Saginaw down here?
It's about 2 hours, give or take 30
and what,
minutes.
And what roads you take come down here?
I take I-75.
Usually. I-75. Mm-hmm. Terrible,
right.
Terrible construction on there right
it's
now.
Horrible, mm-hmm. horrible.
Comes at a bad time, but with the flooding and all that kind of stuff.
Right. Yeah. Well, I avoid that like the plague.
All right. So you said on a recent episode of Only in Monroe that you like to paint your nails in the car when you're coming down.
Oh, great.
And that you made a claim of how fast you can paint your nails.
I said that on TV.
You said it on TV.
I don't remember.
I know.
Let's take a look. Hold on 1 second.
Be careful.
Ladies, let's bank it down for a second. Millward, can we roll that, please?
So how was your road trip? You just came off of teaching.
I had no idea that you could paint 2 nails per red light. So I got all 10 nails painted on my way home from Saginaw.
Oh, that's good.
I didn't, while driving.
Right.
Not me.
Okay, let's recap that claim. You say that you can paint two nails for every red light.
Oh, at least, yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm gonna challenge you on that because we had some research done on this. Legally, stoplights are between 35 and 50 seconds long. So let's just imagine for a second that on average they're 42 seconds long.
Okay.
Can we agree on that?
Yes, sure.
Here's what we're gonna do. Okay. Here, let's put our water to the side. Let's use the basket
away.
In the middle.
Okay.
Exactly, our water. What we're gonna do here is, I need your help on this too, Kaylani. I want you to play a stoplight. There's
Got
red,
it.
There's green.
All
okay.
Right.
Here is hold on. Here is a stopwatch.
All right.
I want you to give us 42 seconds on there. And you and I will each pick a color. Go
pick
ahead.
Pick a color. Okay. Well,
we've got sexy divide. What
I've
do you
got,
have there?
I've got naughty nautical.
I've got Jamaica me crazy.
I'm sorry
that's
about
fun.
That. Okay. How about a bikini sotini? Probably not going to do that.
Meet me at sunrise. And ignite the night.
Okay.
I'm going to go with bikini sotini.
I'm going to choose
there you go.
Jamaica me crazy.
All right, let's
nice.
Do it. Okay,
all
so
right.
Here's how it's going to work.
Okay. Oh.
We have to keep them sealed because you keep them closed while you're driving, right?
Well, yeah,
okay.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
We're going to be pretending like we're driving down the highway. Kaylani mm-hmm. Rarofko-Wilson, you're going to be the green light.
Got it.
At a certain point, switch it to red. We will stop when you start
and I'll
that.
And I'll time you 42.
42
okay,
seconds.
Hold on. How fast are we going and what am I driving?
Driving a Camaro.
Perfect.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm driving a drop-top Camaro.
Nice.
Okay.
And I'm driving a 1967, a fully restored drop-top Mustang.
All right. Okay.
Blue.
Oh, it's on.
All right?
Okay, yeah.
And I'm
no
turning
no.
heads, okay?
You are.
I'm that's what I was wondering.
I'm not saying we're shooting eyes at each other as we drive down the
right,
road.
Right, that's right.
I may have made up to have done that
we're,
before.
We're trading paint.
Right, well.
Okay. Okay, you ready?
That's, oh, wait a minute.
That's
wait
a metaphor for those who are keeping score.
That's right. That's right.
All right, here we go. Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready?
And then I want you to count us down like 5 seconds from the end so we know when to put our caps back on.
All right, got
okay.
it.
Can we start at a stoplight?
No, we're
no,
driving.
You're driving,
we're driving
right
okay,
now.
We're driving.
No, I just
okay, we're driving.
Okay, okay, okay.
And
I
we're driving.
Yes,
no,
okay.
don't take. Okay, ready? All right, and stoplight.
You will also be judged on the neatness of your nails, okay? So don't just power through it, Michelle. You think that just sheer volume is going to win you this thing.
Sheer volume, sheer.
Teeny, bikini so teeny is really thin. I'm not getting the coat that I'm looking for.
I'm trying to not get my side of the nails, although.
Now, do you have brothers and sisters, Michelle?
I do. I have 7 sisters and 2 brothers.
Oh, wow. I had 7 brothers and 3 sisters. And I was basically a dress-up doll for my sisters. So
five,
I learned how to do this.
5, 4, 3.
Cap on.
2, 1.
Lord have mercy. Okay.
All right.
All right.
Oh, it's kind of thick.
It's a moment of judgment.
Okay.
Moment of judgment.
How much did you get?
Now,
oh my gosh.
Your nails were already painted.
This is true.
This is true.
That is.
So we have to see the purple over the red.
Over the red.
Okay.
All right.
Let's take a look.
You
can we get
zoom
a shot
in.
Here?
Gotta zoom in.
Who's on this? Kaylani Rarofko-Wilson.
Michelle, you
look me in the eyes.
I am.
Be honest. Who won?
I know.
Who
I
won.
Think you got it, girl. You got it.
There
you did
go.
So well.
There you go. Oh, I was thinking, you know, next
my co-host
next,
for
next
life.
Month, I know, right? Because he's not going to be here this year next month.
The fix is in.
I know it is.
The
it
fix is.
Is
clearly
but
in.
But look at.
All right.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, Monrovians
yeah,
stick together.
Bit.
That's clear.
Oh.
By the way, how did you guys meet other than talking over
oh,
each other?
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, we do that, don't we?
You do that.
I know,
and
sorry.
You just said do. Which you don't think you can say
on
cable access.
You're not allowed
I'll tell you,
to say
we've got to go take a break. Can you guys stick around after the break?
Yes,
we can.
All right, we'll be right back with more Only in Monroe. How long do these breaks usually last?
30 seconds.
30 seconds long.
That's it.
Does it have to be 30 seconds?
It could be 1 minute.
It could be a minute and a half.
All right. And then what, is there a commercial or something that rolls during
PSA.
This time?
That PSA.
A public service announcement. Mm-hmm. Like Jeff like Daniels doing like the, sure. like yeah. Wander Michigan or.
Right, yes. Yeah, exactly. So if you're like Michigan, that. Tim, what's his name?
Tim Allen.
Tim, okay. Mm-hmm. And then when it's over, we can go back anytime you want?
Yes.
Okay.
We always do.
Nice.
Welcome back. And now it's time for Monroe News. First up, in business news, the Lazy Boy Corporation recently opened their new headquarters in Monroe. As is tradition with all things Lazy Boy, the company's old headquarters will be dragged to the curb for anyone who wants to pick it up. As you may know, following torrential rains, the River Raisin crested today. That flooding recently caused the Monroe Metropolitan Wastewater Treatment Plant to discharge some partially treated sewage. Remember, the sewage is only partially treated, so until further notice, please do not drink any sewage. The band Little Big Town will appear at the Monroe County Fair in August following the removal of singer Jimmy Westbrook's vocal polyp, which, in strict accordance with county fair rules, will be deep fried and sold on a stick. And now, it's time for my turn. Folks, I've been putting this one off for a long time, but it's time to address a sensitive issue that's tearing Monroe apart. I'm talking about the vicious internet flame war between Jerry's Frenchtown Bar and Grill and a Yelper named only Mark M, which means he's totally anonymous among the five Mark M's living in Monroe. Concerning Jerry's, Mr. M recently yelped, "Stopped in for lunch back in the late 90s. You heard right. Mark M is posting about a pre-turn-of-the-century lunch he ate at Jerry's, presumably wearing his JNCOs and Fresh Prince jacket, with his Discman blasting Chumbawamba through his racial haircut. Mark M explains, "Sat at the bar and ordered a regular burger and one O'Doul's. $9.50 for a burger and an O'Doul's? Also, O'Doul's?" Mark raged on, "I was regularly getting a burger and a beer for lunch for half that much everywhere else. I asked the barmaid if maybe she mixed up the bills, and I got a one-word answer. Nope. Did I leave a tip? Nope. Will I ever go back? Nope. Does Mark M sound like someone I want to grab an O'Doul's with? Nope." Well, after spitting 16 years of pent-up lunch fury, Mark M dropped the mic. Then he picked the mic back up again and continued, "And someone apparently representing Jerry's joined Yelp just to send me a nasty message. Classy. Yeah, they didn't even have the decency to wait over a decade before firing back at Mark. They answered only 2 years later. So this thing is really picking up steam at this point." Then Jerry responded, and by Jerry, of course, I mean Brian, the owner of Jerry's, but I call him Jerry because we're tight. Hi, Brian. Jerry Brian Yelp snarked, "I would also like to public apologize to you for trauma you must have received in the 90s while dining at Jerry's, and that you finally came to terms with it and could finally talk about it 14 years later to write a review on Yelp. Let it die." Everyone knows the first rule of business. The customer is always let it die. But JB's got a point here. Mark M has been steaming over his bill for so long, he could have eaten his burger, chugged his O'Doul's, then, in a sober stupor, impregnated a woman, and that baby would now be old enough to vote in next year's election, and then afterwards go to Jerry's as a way of rebelling against her father. I'm sick of hearing that story, old man. He overcharged you $4 in the Clinton administration. Here, just take it. Mark M refused to be intimidated, writing back, "I would not expect anything less than sarcasm and a disingenuous show of concern from you. Also irrelevant is when I had a bad experience in your bar. Yelp didn't even exist then. So how was I to write a review prior to its existence?" That's a fair point. Back before Yelp, the only way to register dissatisfaction with lunch was to burn the restaurant down. I think he showed admirable restraint here. But who's right? Well, as an outsider, it's hard for me to say. You see, where I live in New York City, the best lunch you can get for $9.50 is a bum spitting in your mouth. So was this an exorbitant price to pay for a burger and O'Doul's in the 90s? Well, I had my research team crunch some numbers. And that $9.50 burger and O'Doul's in, let's just say, 1999, adjusted for inflation, would be today $13.56. But in actuality, the current price at Jerry's for that exact same meal with tax is $8.90, less expensive than in the 1990s, unlike my Beanie Babies, which I am sure are now worth millions. This price discrepancy is either a tacit admission of previous price gouging by Jerry, or someone on the internet is making a big deal about nothing. There's no way to know which. But still, it's tearing this community apart, so tonight, I bring peace to this troubled Yelp page. Mark M. feels that $9.50 was twice the amount he should have paid. Therefore, I am pledging to pay him the difference. Mark M., come by the station and pick up this check for $4.75 and let the healing begin. Now, I am going to celebrate the end of this conflict the way it began with the delicious O'Doul's. And I'm going to chase that with a shot of whiskey. We'll be right back.
For over eight generations, any time of the year, folks have been coming to downtown Monroe to shop, eat, be entertained, and connect with friends, old and new. Experience the pleasures of local shopping where the homegrown business owners know you by name, where value isn't just about price, but knowledge, time, and care. Take a break. Slow down. Have coffee, have dinner, or take in a show. We're a real downtown. We are authentic. Authentic downtown Monroe. Rediscover us.
Welcome back to Only in Monroe. I'm only Stephen Colbert, and we are still in Monroe only. My next guest is a local Michigander who is making a name for himself in the competitive world of music. Please welcome Marshall Mathers. Marshall, thanks so much for being here today.
Thanks for having me.
Pleasure. Now, are you from the Monroe area?
I am not. I am from the Michigan area.
But you are a native
from
Michigander.
Detroit, yeah.
You're from Detroit. Oh, Detroit. Okay. How'd you get down here today? Did you take I-75?
Yep.
Traffic's pretty tough right now. There's a lot of construction.
Yeah.
Yeah, plus with all the flooding.
Right.
Yeah. You know the River Raisin is crested?
I did not
know.
Didn't know that? No.
The important thing is just don't drink any sewage. All right? Just do for the next 24 hours. Okay? Fight it. So, from Detroit, who are some of your big musical influences? I imagine Motown, Ted Nugent, obviously, Seger?
Bob Seger's great, yeah.
He's great. Okay, let's see how much of a Michigan native you are. I'll name some Bob Seger songs and you see whether you can sing any part of them, okay? Against the Wind.
Against the Wind. Running Against the Wind.
That's pretty good. Well, I gave that one away because it's in the title. Okay, how about Like a Rock?
I forget the melody.
Like a rock! There is actually no melody. He just screams like a rock for 3 minutes, and then they roll trucks by. I think the video was just is it Chevy trucks? Is it Chevy? Just all Chevy trucks. Night Moves.
I know the song, I forget
Little
the melody.
Too tall, could use a few pounds.
Give me the hook. Where's it?
Night Moves. Night Moves. Yeah.
Okay.
Fire Lake. Who wants to go to Fire Lake? Strut. Oh, I love to watch a strut. Jump in anytime here. Kathmandu.
That was good.
Thank you.
That was good.
You claim you're from Michigan.
I don't know any of these songs. I know Kathmandu. There's a couple of them.
Rock and Roll Never Forgets Anything. Rock and Roll Never Forgets. Okay. Roll Me Away, Won't You Roll Me Away. Turn the Page.
Yep.
Someday, lady, you'll accompany me. Are these ringing any bells?
Yes, they
are.
You're going really fast, though. Like, I can't.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were a rapper. Don't rappers talk fast? Are you one of those slow-talking rappers or one of the fast-talking rappers?
Can be both, I guess.
Old-time rock and roll. I'll throw you a softball here. Old-time rock and roll.
I like that old-time rock and roll.
Yeah, Tom Cruise in the underwear.
Just sues us.
So, that's exactly right. All right. So what kind of, let's talk about your career, enough Bob Seger. What kind of rap do you do? Are you like sort of sing-songy rap like Bone Thugs and Harmony, or are you more like street like Will Smith?
Well, I like Bone Thugs and I like Will Smith.
Okay. Which are you closer to?
Middle.
The middle? Okay.
Probably.
Are you political? Because a lot of rap is very political, and some of it is just like good booty rhymes. Are you more political or are you more booty rhymes?
In the middle?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I kind of...
Right in the middle of the booty?
Right in the crack, probably.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a steamy place.
Yeah.
To have your career.
Right.
All right.
Steamy place to be.
Mm-hmm. I noticed on a lot of rap songs, and you know more than I do about this because you're in the rap world. A lot of times it'll say feet, you know, like they'll say like someone's song, whoever, Rihanna, feet, Pitbull, or something like that. It often says feet, Pitbull. I think Pitbull's my first name might actually be feet. Have you ever been feet, Marshall Mathers? Have you ever feeted?
I have feeted.
Mm-hmm.
What
does
it
mean when you're feeding? When it says feet, what does that
featuring?
Mean? Featuring. Oh, featuring. Okay, so it's just somebody you're helping. Mm-hmm. Can we see his face? He's got a hoodie on. Can we see his face? Is lighting okay with that? Are we okay with that? Okay. Have you thought about taking the hoodie down? Because you've got, you know, just as an entertainer, and I'm in the entertainment industry, you've got such a cute face. Why hide it underneath
thanks.
The hoodie?
That's
your little moneymaker.
Yeah,
why hide?
Well,
why? Nah, you should probably put the hood back.
Yeah, probably. Okay.
Yeah, my mistake. You know your business. You know business better than I do. Can we get serious for a second?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Sure.
Do you worry about the kids listening to rap? Because some of it gets pretty rough with the this and the bomb that.
Oh, I don't do any of that.
You don't?
No.
You keep it clean?
Keep it clean.
Give a message to the rappers out there who are dropping that kind of language and say, tell them, like, you don't have to do it.
You don't have to do it. Watch your mouths.
Okay. Thank you. That is refreshing. That is refreshing. All right. So where do you hope this goes? Is this a career or more of a hobby? Is this sort of like a thing to do with your buddies on the weekends?
It's both.
That's good.
It's a career and a hobby.
Okay, it's a pretty tough business though, you know? Do you have a fallback position? Is there something else you know how to do, like carpentry or HVAC? Everybody needs HVAC. We're always gonna need HVAC.
Carpentry sounds
mm-hmm.
like it could be
mm-hmm.
good.
Mm-hmm. Do you have what I'm saying is that, how old are you?
42.
42. If you ever want to have a family and, you know, care for them, while it's fun, and obviously everybody should have something fun they do when they have time, you should really have something. And this is nothing about your talent. This is an older man talking to a younger man about what you're going to need to have in place 10 years from now. You need to think 10 years down the line, am I going to have a retirement account? You just have to make plans for when the dream dies. And, you know, dreams die. You know, it happens. And fun is fun.
I'm so confused right now. I'm trying to figure out if you're serious or if...
I'm very serious. If you don't have a retirement account by the time you're 50, you're dead in the water. There's nothing to be done at that point. You're a greeter at Walmart at that point.
Yeah, no,
you're
I
like, hi,
I
I'm Marshall.
Though.
Children's toys are over that way.
Right.
You're dead.
Right.
You're going, why don't I listen to him?
No,
I understand this is probably important to you on a certain level, and you probably told your friends, I'm going to make it. I'm going to be the guy who doesn't give up. You told your parents, is this good enough for you, old man? But there's a certain point you have to be humble and say, maybe it doesn't happen for
right.
me. Maybe it doesn't happen for you, Marshall.
You really don't know. I mean, I put out like quite a few albums.
Well, I'm sure that feels good.
It does.
It does. Well, good. Doesn't pay the rent. Like what? What would I know?
I mean, it sort of does. Pay the rent.
It pays the rent?
Yeah.
Good. Mm-hmm. What have you done? I mean, because if you're, and
are
I apologize.
Are you serious right now?
And
I'm
apologize,
trying to figure out if
I'm
you're
not,
serious right
I'm
now.
Not, I'm not, I'm, listen.
I'm not
thing.
Trying to
I'd
be
like to apologize. If you're a bigger deal than I know about, here's the thing. This is all my research, people. I want to know who you are. I just don't know who you are.
That's fine.
Okay, good. But you seem pretty mad.
I'm not mad at all.
Not mad at all. Okay, well, you were getting pretty angry a second ago.
I think I just look angry.
Yeah, well, that's good. That works for rap.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you've done some stuff. You've got an album. You've featured on somebody. You featured with people.
I featured on somebody.
You featured on somebody.
I featured on quite a few somebodies.
Okay, good. So now you're getting angry again.
No. Not at all. I'm just trying to figure out why I'm here.
As far as I know, somebody's got a project to push on Only in Monroe, and I will do my best to do it now since you evidently only want to do that. All right, so you've got a movie, and it's called Southpaw. And I'll do the introductions, thank you. Southpaw, and it stars Jake Gyllenhaal.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Fine. It's Jake Gyllenhaal with two A's. And you produced it, and you did the soundtrack for it, and I believe we have a clip. Millward?
I am forgiven! Every ounce of my blood, with every breath in my lungs, won't stop until I'm for nothing, no. However long it takes, I'll go to whatever lengths. It's gonna make me a monster, though.
I'm sorry, I apologize. There's also a cat doctor who does a show on the cable access show here, and I think that was the cat doctor's footage. It's pretty good, though. Is that anything like that in the movie?
I mean, that was the song.
Do we have the right tape? Probably there's a VHS tape up there that says the right clip or Gyllenhaal or something on the side. Can we play that?
I am forgiven!
How'd you like to fight for that title?
You think that you can beat Magic?
Not without you.
I'm gonna fight again. I'm gonna get my kid back.
What chance is there that Hope could win?
The cards are stacked against Hope.
They say Billy Hope can't make it. Billy Hope is over. This is your time. This is your moment.
You can control your destiny.
Well, it's great. Now, you wrote all that music?
Yeah. I mean, that song.
Yeah, that's a beautiful song.
Thanks.
It worries me a little bit, though. Can I spit some of your lyrics back at you? And am I using the term correctly? Spit.
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right. The song is called Phenomenal, and it goes a little bit like this. Okay. By the way, Jake is jacked in that. Is he always like that, or did he get jacked for that movie? He's super jacked.
Yeah, I'm not sure. You have to ask him.
He's really fit. That's just not. That's not what he's normally like. You have to know that.
You're
the producer of the movie. You have to know that he didn't look like that beforehand, right? When you hired him.
They put his head on my body.
Really?
For that shot.
You work out?
Yeah.
Come on. Flex on. Flex on. Flex off. Give me a little.
Oh,
I
mean, you really
action.
Can't. It's really nothing. Nothing.
That is. Come on, man. Do you want to go? Are you about to go?
Flex.
Were we about to go?
Not unless you wanted to, I mean.
I don't want to, but I will not back down. If you were about to go, I'm not backing down. You're in my house.
If you were about to...
You come into my house. You come into my house, and you flex up on me, and you expect me to back down? You are sadly mistaken. Hoodie? Yeah.
Not sure what to do here.
No. No, you don't.
It's quite frightening.
I would keep it that way.
It's quite frightening.
All right, you stay confused.
I am really confused right now.
All right, let's talk about your lyrics. I'm sorry. I was fronting. I want to apologize.
That you were.
I was fronting.
That you were.
These are the lyrics. You say, I am phenomenal. However long it takes, I'll go to whatever lengths. It's going to make me a monster, though. The question is here, is that a message you're sending to the kids, which is, if you reach for your dreams, okay, you can be the best, but it's going to turn you into some sort of unrecognizable monster that you'll regret. Is that the message?
Not necessarily, but...
That's what the lyrics say.
I mean, that's, I guess maybe that's your interpretation of them.
It says, "It's I am phenomenal, however long it takes, I'll go to whatever lengths, it's gonna make me a monster though."
I'm just saying, whatever.
Do you have to be a monster to be phenomenal?
I mean, you don't have to be, but what I'm saying is, if I go to these lengths and these extremes and however, if I keep trying, it's gonna turn, my perseverance is gonna turn me into something other than human, an animal.
Has that happened to you, Marshall?
Maybe metaphorically speaking.
Well, yeah. I can understand that.
Yeah.
And I ask for personal reasons because I'm going to start a new project in the fall. And I'd like to be phenomenal, but I don't want to turn into a monster. Is it possible? I guess what I'm asking is it possible to be phenomenal and not lose your humanity?
I mean, you have to find a balance.
What is the balance? How do you find the balance? Do you do hot yoga?
No, I meditate a lot.
Do you really meditate?
Yeah.
I know obviously you can teach me.
I'm meditating right now.
Really?
Yeah, because this is really weird.
Now, I understand that Southpaw comes out July 24th. Will it be playing only in Monroe or all across Michigan?
It should be playing all across Michigan.
Okay, good.
And hopefully beyond.
Okay, well, congratulations. That is phenomenal. Anything you want to say to the local people in Monroe?
What up, Monroe?
Well, Marshall Mathers, thank you so much for joining me.
Am I performing next? Or?
That would be great, but we are kind of tight on time, okay? Come back in August, because I think I'm hosting again then, and you'll be phenomenal. Marshall Mathers, we'll be right back.
For over 8 generations, any time of the year, folks have been coming to downtown Monroe to shop, eat, be entertained, and connect with friends, old and new. Experience the pleasures of local shopping where the homegrown business owners know you by name, where value isn't just about price, but knowledge, time, and care. Take a break, slow down, have coffee, have dinner, or take in a show. We're a real downtown. We are authentic. Authentic downtown Monroe. Rediscover us.
First record was in 99.
Oh,
with
yeah.
Dr. Dre.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, you did that thing with Elton John at the Grammys.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah,
I apologize. Yeah, I know who you are. I know who you are.
Okay.
You're the dude who did the thing with Elton John at the Grammys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wonder yeah, I did.
Why.
Right. So you know it.
Yeah.
Can I perform now?
No, we don't have time. Well, that's all the time we have for Only in Monroe, but before we go, let's take a peek at Monroe's community calendar. Marshall, you want to help me out with this?
Well, it says on the teleprompter that I'm supposed to say I'd love to, Stephen.
That's great. Thanks. On July 1st, an infant CPR safety and care class will be offered from 10 a.m. to noon. So if you're an infant interested in CPR or just a fan of unobstructed breathing, head on down to the Monroe County Health Department, 2353 South Custer Road. Marshall?
And remember to check out the River Raisin Independence Festival and fireworks on July 3rd. You can celebrate America's independence from England and Monroe's independence from celebrating the 4th on the 4th. It's your last chance to see fireworks in Monroe until New Year's Eve on December 30th.
Tuesday, July 7th is the monthly meeting of the Monroe Coin Club. Stop by if you're a numismatist or if Tuesday is laundry day and you just need to break a single.
Wednesday, July 8th, Kinetic Chiropractic at 2059 North Monroe Street will offer a free class for handling stress. No late admission. Get it together for once in your life and show up on time.
On July 15th, stop by City Hall for Beginning Birding Basics. Reminder for birders, vests with under 8 pockets will not be admitted.
July 22nd is the Monroe Mayor's Traffic Committee. All traffic officials are required to be at the meeting, so if you're on the road between 5 and 7 p.m., floor it.
Well, that's community calendar for July. What month comes next? Find out next time, only on
Only in Monroe.
Before we go, I'd like to thank everyone at MPACT Thank you all so much. We couldn't have done it without you. And if you're in Monroe, make sure you stop by Larson's Bar and Grill and ask for Alex. You won't regret it. I also want to thank my guest, Marshall Mathers. Thank you, Marshall. But mostly, Michelle Bauman and Kehlani Ray Rafko Wilson. Goodbye, ladies. As you say in Monroe, I'll leave the keys under the mat. So long. Oh, that's good.
Okay. MPACT. Hopefully this has a lot of impact.
Try not to talk during this part. I'm sorry.
How long are we doing?
We just keep it a little longer. Let's just give a nice long one with no talking.